Hey guys, your boy Kerberz, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool Karma War. Last time off, I finished off the December games, and now we are into the January transfer window of 2017. And it is my mission in this window to replace the leaving Daniel Sturridge. I have put in bids for some players. You might sign one of those big name players in this episode, and Daniel Sturridge is involved in most of the bids that I made. Why? Because he wants to even, and none of the teams I've offered him to are in the Premier League, for obvious reasons. But first, we're playing the Milton Keynes Dons in the FA Cup. As you can see, I'm putting out quite along my talent, including Brannigan getting his first run out of the season. And hopefully, if he performs well, some club will loan him. Some club that will actually play him. Hint, hint, Middlesbrough. Except for the Moreno and my center backs, everyone else is. He's new, and of course, Danny Ings. It's because, apparently, I don't have that many strikers. But I have... If I was going to play for my regular formation, but... Ergie was still a little bit tired, so I decided to go for the 4-5-1. This way, I get to play both Costa and Brannigan. Martin Costa run out. He seems to be a very good young talent, and I am so excited to see what he can develop into. Might have the new David Silva on my hands right here, or you never know. And he is Spanish, so that could be quite an accurate description. FA Cup, blah blah blah. This is what everyone is here for. And this is actually my first video being recorded with a new headset. It's because I got a comment telling me that the one I was using all the time didn't sound the best. So hopefully this one will sound a bit better. Or if not, a creek without a paddle. Because I'm not buying any more. Luckily, I found one that the internet recommended. Nice and cheap, because I haven't started making that YouTube dollar money just yet. And that's a foul there by the Milton Keynes player. Yeah, a bit early there to get him into the book. Fair to give him just a warning. Here's Meles. Wait, what the hell? Who the hell is that? Oh wait, that's my right back. I was like, I didn't recognize his name. This is actually the first time I'm playing him. Him since I brought him up from the youth. Ooh, scouts. I didn't actually get the chance to use him in preseason because I only signed him up just before they started the main season. So he didn't get a chance to play in preseason. Paulette, who's like a mopless hair version of Marouane Fellaini. So basically, he's the good Fellaini. I never thought I'd hear those words come out of my mouth, but I've actually found them. So there you go. It is possible. It is possible. Brannigan. Oh, come on. Is it Connor? Every time I hear his surname, I just think of the guy from Futurama. You know that weird stalker, creepy guy. He who's obsessed with Leela? Not Friday, our guy. Any Futurama fans will know instantly who I'm talking about. The weird guy. He Amy's boyfriend works for. Zap, isn't it? I haven't watched Futurama in I don't know how long, so this is just rough memory I'm going on here. I could be thinking of a totally different Oh, I think there was a Brian. I think it was Futurama. I could be wrong. You know, let's talk about the football, okay? Let's not talk about whole canceled TV shows. Come on, Ings! Oh, fucking hell, how did that keeper get there for me? What a dick. Come on. What kind of... Yes, Brangan! Ings! Can you set up the first goal? Are you shitting me? How did you not score? That's like... The goal was practically put on a silver platter for you, Danny. Hey, God damn it. I don't know who I have on the bench, but things want to make sure I don't call upon whoever's on there. It's probably Correa and Daniel Sturridge, to be honest. Normally what I have, I don't have any art. Well, I have Alberto. It might be Correa and Alberto, to be honest. Or is it Origi? If the need arises, we will see. Yeah, I guess. Oh, this Martin guy's pissing me off. Is this Jack Butland in disguise or some shit? Ah, wow, well done, referee. I wasn't on an attack. No, you were imagining that. We were all imagining that. Let's see. Just quick scan for other Premier League teams. You know you're drawing with Bradford. Of course, why not? Because, then again, I'm drawing with Milton Keynes Don, so I can't really say anything. Arsenal are drawing, Everton are drawing. Well, we're all drawing. I don't see Chelsea. There they are. They're being Middlesbrough. They're actually playing a Premier League team. The team in the bottom of the table, but they're playing them. Come on, Brannigan. What a pass to pull it. Pull it. Back to... If you had a better touch, you'd have scored. And Costa skies it, you fucking moron. Absolutely massive news about Leo Messi. Oh, come on, game. That was supposed to be a surprise. Well, there's one of the surprises ruined. You're lucky Messi's not the only player I'd bid for. But yeah, that could be one of the... That is one of the potential targets I've bid for. I've bid for a few, but Messi is one of them. Will I get the best player in the world in the Liverpool shirt? I could, you know. Maybe a cheeky offer Barcelona might be interested in. You never know. You never know. Might be a cheeky offer they're interested in. Who knows? I mean, as long as they keep Sturridge health, he they're getting a decent striker. Plus, they can reform SAS because they have Suarez. Oh wait, he moved to Bayern, didn't he? Moving on, Danny Ings has scored, and just before I was considering subbing you, so you're lucky as hell there, Danny. It took 58 minutes to get past that goalkeeper. It was actually Brannigan with the win, so it's an assist for Brannigan. It's good. Might get him some attention. He's actually been really good so far in this match. It's despite the scoreline depicting that we have not been our best. Again, I've not played my best team. Although this team should still... will be... He's steamrolling MK Dons, no disrespect, but come on. And these players play for the champions of not only the Premier League, but the Europa League as well. And by the end of this season, the Champions League. So they should be better than this. It'd help if they weren't constantly... He's stopping runs. Seriously, Costa, he took the ball off the guy. He and didn't run to get hit it. Instead, he just left it there for the MK Dons player to get. And here comes Barrett, who is actually on loan from me. They brought on my own player against me. And now he's in the box. Oh, shit. Laurie, he was like, nah, this is not happening. Go on. Go on. Go on, Ings is away. Surely. 2-0. Has to be. Yes! Martin, he almost denied that one as well. But Danny Ings scores again. And it's 2-0. That's more like it. A little bit more like it. But it's, you know, it's still not really a convincing scoreline. It should be 3 or 4-0. Or at minimum. As far as I'm concerned... MK Dons are at least still in League One. They could be in the Championship, I don't know. They may have gotten promoted, they may not have. And they might be in League Two. They may have gotten relegated, they might not have. And again, I don't know. Oh, not... Didn't really look at who got promoted and relegated from any division last season. I didn't even know until the season started that Palace were gone. Ings for the hat trick! Are you shitting me? Hey. Yes! They made a critical defensive error. Dang Ings for the hat trick! There it is! The match ball is yours, Danny boy. Hey, 3-0. That's looking much better than it was at half time. Blew it past Martin, and he's been saving things for fun in this match, which was really pissing me off. But finally, Danny Ings has beaten him not once, not twice, but 3 times. Thank you very much, Danny. That's very good. Sometimes the forgotten striker is Danny Ings. He's not had a real good shot in the first team, probably the only striker I have that hasn't. Who knows? Maybe he's trying to convince me that spot shouldn't be. I shouldn't waste my money. Yeah, I should just promote him. I would still need to buy a striker to replace him on the second team. Or I'd have to change formation and. Well, this was fun. I don't think I'll be using 4-5-1 again, unless necessary, anytime soon. That was a terrible ball. No one was making a run. It's not going to matter. It's 3-0. Game over. I'll take the progression. Costa! Imagine if that had gone in. Anyway, it is 3. You know, all goals from Danny Ings. And there he is getting the match ball over his for himself. David Martin, go kill yourself, mate. You're a horrible person. Arsenal lost, Man United drew. I assume Chelsea won, Everton drew. So not, you know, not the other my fellow Premier League teams didn't exactly have what you would call the best results. Why are they so incompetent this year? Seriously. Heath, they're as bad as the teams are in real life. Heath. Heath. I mean, I'm running away with the league, and no one seems to be in any have any interest in stopping me. Come on, come on. Please. Ooh, few transfer offers accepted. The offer for Lacazette was accepted. The offer for one of for someone, just someone, yeah. Oh, like Cristiano Ronaldo. Accepted. I mean, that was a pretty fair deal. 123 million plus for Mino. Yeah, the offer for Lewandowski was accepted. Oh, that's Neymar's. Yep. I bid for everyone. And I'm going to offer contracts to them all because, you know, I did. And when the time comes, I will make my decision. So there you go, Lacazette. 4 years, 22,000, as you wished. You asked for three, I give you four. That's how this works. CR7, obviously, gonna have to give you a lot of fucking money, or you're not gonna come. Right, $650. So I have some if wages left over. Robert Lewandowski, 275 he wishes to have. I will give him 275, no problem. And I like how the game told me Barcelona wouldn't sell Neymar to me, but look at this. Yeah, what do you call that game? Exactly. I can sign anyone I damn well please. If I want Neymar, I will get him. I should just go for Neymar to spite this game. He meant it's stupidity. In any event, almost forgot. There we go. Almost forgot to put the first team back in to the rotation. In for this Merseyside derby. Oh, Jordan Henderson went up. Welcome to the party, Henderson. You're a bit late. Now, Correa, if you could jump up to... Ooh, that'd be fantastic. Then everyone would be at least 83, except for the goalkeeper who's just chilling there on 76. And still awesome. Because why not? Because why not? Right? Seriously, Everton. Not going to be that stupid in the game. That. Chelsea concede 14, Arsenal 17, United 19, City 22. Me? Just the two. Just the two. is Bale. Nathaniel Klein whips it in. I'm looking for that early drop of blood. And that will signify a weakness is for the Blues of Merseyside. I'll take that throw. Thank you much, LFAU. Laporte for Varane. For Daniel Sturridge, finds him pretty goddamn easy because Baines is asleep. Still recovering from those injuries he has in real life, if apparently. It's eventually Stones who clears it. Jordan Henderson. Come on. Should be giving a free kick for the foul on Henderson as I was taking the shot. Could he be coming back? You will have to wait and see. You surprise ruining assholes. Weirdly enough, the surprise they ruined Messi's offer or wasn't accepted yet. If it will be at all. Probably will be. Let them a fair deal for Messi. Here's the goal from Watford. It's a goal from Manchester City. It's been scored by Yaya Touré. Equalizes for Manchester City against Watford. We're actually playing Watford this weekend. Should be, a tough game. Watford playing very well. Oh, obviously not as well as Leicester, but you get my picture. They are playing very well with Deeney and Ighalo. Hope I said his name right. God damn it, Rod. Cardo. Oh, why did you think I was telling you to do that? Seriously, what did that accomplish? That didn't accomplish anything at all. Seriously. Go. Go, Royce. Go. Whip it in. Daniel, I mean, I know you're thinking of what's next for you, but come on. Man, head in the game. Oof! Everton got really... They got too close. It was actually Gibson. Who... I didn't even know he still played for Everton. How few appearances he makes for them. Oh shit! That was Gibson again! Fucking hell! Oh! It was Gibson again! Fucking hell! No, I don't know why I showed Barkley, it was Gibson, who seems to be Everton's biggest goal scoring threat in this match. Fucking close that fucker down. Morales! Ooh! Luckily my keeper was equal to it. That's an. Klein, go Bale, go. No, don't. Don't have time to control it. Come on, Gareth. Yes, Gareth. Run, Gareth. All the way, Gareth. Whip it back. Coutinho! Straight at fucking Howard. Brilliant. Oh yes, Mraz with the mistake. Sturridge. Boom. Bottom corner. That is how you go. Oh, if this is his last match, he's going to be remembered. The mistake by Morales. Pounced on by Daniel Sturridge. Buries it in the bottom corner. Doesn't give if Tim Howard or that chance. It's, even if he is a good goalkeeper. Or I don't care what keeper you put in front of that. And no keeper would save that. Not even Neuer. 17th goal. Could be his last. Hopefully won't be his last. Might be his last, unfortunately. It was definitely the last thing of interest in the first half. That is one hell of a way to finish the first half. Chelsea are playing United. Lovely if they could draw and each of them drop points. Although Chelsea are closer to me than United. But I am not gonna hope for a United win. I would much rather a draw. And hope that. Here I come. Continue. Yo, we could have a quick second after late first. Continue. Corner. It's actually out off Gibson, which is hilarious. Just considering how much danger he caused at this goal in the first half. Gray wasn't totally ready for it. There was a Laporte. He might. Players didn't seem to know what I was trying to do. There. Yes, that's much better. Her Merrick. Whip it in. In. Was that Sturridge or was it Correa? I think it's giving it to Correa. I don't know. They were both there. And it looked like they almost both headed it. It's telling me to celebrate with Correa, so I'm assuming it's Correa's goal. Let's see this. Oh yeah, Sturridge didn't header it at all. He would have probably headed it out, actually. Or into the bottom corner. Either way, it's in. It's Correa's goal. Well, for sure. Her Sturridge was just trying to confuse me. Hey, damn it, Daniel. Well, the 2-0 event. Correa with his 12th goal of the season. Just widen the margin here to 2-0. It's been a goal at St. James's Park, Alan McAnally. It's a goal for Newcastle United. 57 minutes, please. Oh, yes. Newcastle. Oh, brilliant. Newcastle have drawn back level against Arsenal to remitter it. My boy from FIFA 15. In his cup. He ate again as he did so many times in that game. He may have just helped me open a further 2-point cushion. And adding the cushion. You know, just stuff more into that bad boy. He was already clear that Arsenal weren't going to catch me. Now it's more clear. Daniel Sturridge! Oh, come on, Daniel. I didn't hit it first time because I didn't think he'd score. I was waiting. I was waiting. Eventually, I took the shot and it just didn't go in. Darren Gibson has gone off. Thank Christ. He's at the end of that debacle. Hopefully, Tom Cleverley won't cause me as much trouble as Gibson did. Oh, that's going to be a yellow card for Marco Reus. Marco, it's just be better if you just let him book you. Oh. Or he's not going to? Wow, even I thought that was a yellow card. Yeah, I think so. Heard. I'm surprised, actually. If I was a referee, I would have given a yellow card for that. Anyway, Marco Reus got off with just a warning, I guess. How I'm not even sure. Go, Gareth, go. Oh. Correa. Ah, oh, I was trying for the pass through the storage. Henderson. Yes. Yes. Daniel. One more. Yes. There it is. A second goal for Daniel Sturridge. The Everton fans are horribly disappointed. It's too bad they haven't put in the animation of fans leaving yet, because you know where Everton fans wouldn't be sticking around for this shit. They'd be like, fuck this, I'm going home. 3-0 down at Anfield? Nah. Even the most hard-headed Everton fans would be like, nah, this match is over. The fans are absolutely loving life over there. All around the ground. Correa might get at number 4, and he has! Oh, seriously, EA. FIFA 17 adding annotations of fans leaving when their teams are shit. It, or being stomped out. As is, you're just subjecting poor Everton fans to a demolition. Well, I'm subjecting Everton to the demolition, but you're subjecting them to watching it. I mean, no Everton fan is going to click on this unless they... this video, unless they think, oh, maybe if I watch this, he'll lose some matches and I can laugh at him. That's the only reason an Everton fan would watch a video about Liverpool. Oh, was if they get the chance to laugh at us. That's how it works. Do you even rival EA? Hey, Correa for the hat trick! Coutinho gets his goal. You know he was gonna. Yo, you left Sturridge hanging. You went like, yeah! Oh, you're gonna hug Bale? Like, this could be like my last match, and you're not gonna hug me? Anyway, it is it's 5-0 now. Realistically, the nature of the game, there's nothing false about it. They've thoroughly deserved to be so far ahead. And the added time will amount to... Sturridge was the only person in... I thought I'd catch Howard out. There's the fans holding up their very blurry scarves. But I think it's safe to say they're singing in that old famous song. And to the tune of a 5-0 Merseyside victory. That was the last time a Merseyside derby ended 5-0. Where's the realism, EA? I'm just too good. I'm too good for legendary. Seriously, they need to add ultimate as a difficulty for career mode. Is that so hard to... is that too much to ask? Oh, wow, you know, I actually did get a draw. Haha, that's brilliant. Spurs are losing as well. Although they're fifth. 5 emails. That piss off city. Yeah, see, I told you I made a fair deal. Oh, and they agree. He. So much so that they're like, yeah, sure, that's a perfect deal. Oh, 3 here is crucial first team player. Why not? I mean, he's like no motherfucking Messi. Best player in the world. Anton Griezmann. Why not? May have a bid for him as well. Why not? Because he's awesome. Rumors linking us to him in real life as well, so might be a realistic signing. Donson, I'm giving you as much game time as I can, but I don't have enough cup games, mate. Luckily for you, I have some coming up. Hang on in there. I think I have one in the next game. In the next episode. Oh no. It's two league games in the next episode. Leicester and West Brom. So ironic, we just played West Brom in life and had to snatch it off from them, and Leicester is the game we're playing after Watford. So, you know, the game is like intertwining with life fixtures. There's what are you doing to me, game? Can we finish off anyway? I've gotten an offer for Daniel Sturridge. No, I'm not accepting a 2-year loan from Manchester City. You're not going to play him. I'm not falling for that. Newcastle, look, I have nothing against Newcastle, but come on. Why would I sell my best player to a Premier League rival? Why would I do that? Look, if you can give me 72 million. Actually, fuck that. I want 85. I want a good deal. 72 million is cheap for the amount of goals Daniel Sturridge has gotten, not just last season, but this one as well. Especially a Premier League rival, you're lucky I don't up it to 90 million. So, that would shit all over my deals. That would actually only leave Neymar or Ronaldo and possibly Aguero. Because every other deal has Sturridge involved. Oh, what will happen in the next episode? Will I make a historic signing for Liverpool Football Club? You'll have to wait and see. Yeah, until next time, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Like, comment, and subscribe if you did. I'll see you all.